Good afternoon, class. Today we are going to emphasize on communication skills. You all must have learned about communication skills in our offline class, but again we'll have a revision on it, what all we have gone through. Communication skill. Okay, so what is this communication skill? Can anyone tell me what is communication and why it has been included in our computer syllabus? See, communication is the basic of everything. It is playing a vital role in our daily routine. Communication is a two-way process of giving and receiving information. And the reason why it has been included in our computer, because even if computer is a technique, still to deal with this technology, you need to communicate. So the very basic skill before being a computer engineer, computer technician, you need to know how to communicate. So all that essential communication skills we are going to learn in this topic. So this communication can be anything. For example, we sit in a school and listen to teachers. So that is a sort of communication. We talk with our friends. We read books and magazines. We watch television. So this all comes under communication. So someone is a sender, someone is a receiver. So you are sending and receiving an information. Okay, for communication you require a medium. So the medium can be anything, a newspaper, a Facebook, a social networking site, face-to-face communication, indirect communication, third-party communication. So these all are different ways of communication. Okay, now which all are the different forms of communication? Can you all see the chart over here? See, there are basically, this communication is categorized into three: verbal, non-verbal, visual. Verbal, that is oral communication, which includes spoken and written. Non-verbal communication includes your body language, your gestures, your postures, the way you dress up, the way you speak, the way you stand, the way you express, your eye contacts, your paralanguage, your facial expressions, the space, the touch, the feel which you give. This all are included in non-verbal communication. Okay, now next is visual. What is visual communication? Visual communication is like, just by seeing you understand. For example, the hoardings, the graph, the maps, the drawings, diagrams, objects. So the moment you see, the moment you see a barricade on a road, you understand that this road is having no vehicle. Vehicles have been banned over here. The moment you see a red signal, it indicates that it is, the red says stop. If it is green, it says you are allowed to go. So that means the maps, the graphs, they speaks a lot. So that comes under visual communication. Okay, now we will start emphasizing on verbal communication. What is this verbal communication? Communication done through word of mouth and writing. That is, it can be face-to-face communication or telephonic conversation. So in verbal communication, you have face-to-face direct conversation. It is the very most effective way of communication. See, taking an interview, group discussion, sitting in a class, the teacher understands the expressions of the kids. And the teacher can recognize whether he is paying attention or he is physically present, mentally absent. So this is somewhere missing in our online lectures, because we are delivering the lectures, you are sitting at home, the way you are expressing, the way you are reacting for our lectures, we don't know. Why? Because there is no face-to-face communication. Next, verbal communication is telephonic conversation. So what is telephonic conversation? It is sharing of information via phone, mobile. So you're calling to your granny, you're calling to your parents, you're calling to your relatives, friends staying away from you and having a long conversation is called as telephonic conversation, where you may not see the facial expressions, but the way of the level of volume, the pitch, you can recognize their feelings. Next is written communication. See, the documents, the magazine, the SMS, now the written communication has been getting more important, because in written communication, right now people feel better to send a message on WhatsApp. So invitations, marriage invitations, group invitations, any function invitations, you just get by an SMS. You don't have to actually have a telephonic conversation. So written communication is also playing a vital role nowadays. Okay. Next, we will jump towards the second type of communication, that is non-verbal communication. So what is non-verbal communication? It is a behavior or action other than spoken or written communication that occurs without use of the words. So body language, facial expressions, eye contact, body postures, appearance, your proximity, personal space, paralanguage, this all comes under non-verbal communication. And in visual communication, the symbols, the pictures, they speak. The symbols, the pictures, they speak 1,000 words. So, a band towards U-turn. A board, a signboard over there will indicate on the road that you are not allowed to take a U-turn. Okay. So there are various symbols which speaks 1,000 words. Now we will see towards the cycle. See, there is a communication cycle. As I said, if I want to communicate with you right now, the medium which I'm using is a technology. I'm using YouTube. I'm using my mobile for recording. I'm using my computer for typing and presentation. I'm making use of internet through which I can reach to you. So there's a medium. Okay, so this communication is not one way. It is two way, and it requires communication medium. So we will see the cycle of communication. The process of communication starts when the sender wants to transmit fact, idea, opinion, or other information to receiver, and ends with receiver's feedback. So there's an idea by a sender, then he does encoding, then he chooses the channel, then it gets decoded, and then the receiver receives. So in between a channel, there may be noise, there may be unwanted sound, there may be feedback. Okay. Importance of feedback. See, feedback plays a very vital role in your communication. The benefits of giving positive feedback to employees. So, if there's a communication at the end, it should conclude with a feedback. It can be lower turnover rate, greater profitability. A feedback may be positive, negative. Okay. Now, what all are the barriers of effective communication? See, where do you face a problem while having effective communication? Can anyone tell me? See, effective communication may have the barriers like language barrier. For example, I have been on a visit to, suppose, say, Kerala, and there the people over there, they don't understand Hindi, they don't understand English, and I don't understand their language. So I want to communicate with them. They want to communicate with me, but there's a barrier. Which is that barrier? Language barrier. There's a cultural barrier. See, for example, I am born and brought up here in Maharashtra. So all the, the trends which I have been learned since my childhood, that all are been, means my culture is different. And now suddenly if I'll go to any of the foreign countries, so it will take some of a time, and there will be a barrier in between their culture and my culture. There can also be a personal barrier. Personal barrier in sense, suppose if I'm not having open-minded personality and a person in front of me is trying to speak out, and if I am mentally somewhere else, then there can be a personal barrier in the communication. Psychological barrier is again the same. In psychological barrier, you may not understand, you don't want to get connected with the person, the sender. So even if you will speak 1,000 words, you are unable to receive. There can be gender barrier. See, the way you speak with a lady may not be the same way applied to speak with a gents. Same way, if two gents are having the conversation, they may not share the same conversation with a girl. So there comes a gender barrier. There can be emotional barrier. See, there are some people where you can easily get attached with. There are some people you don't get plugged in. So there's a emotional barrier. There's interpersonal barrier. Suppose you have some conflict with someone and now you want to get in conversation with that person, you may not easily get connected. There can be environmental barriers. Environmental barriers are the barriers which are caused due to some environmental changes, causes, and it is out of control. There can be organizational barriers. Okay, now we will see how to overcome this all barriers. The very first solution is you always need to be good listener. See, always the communication cannot be effective only if a speaker is a fluent speaker. If you people are not a good listener, then the feedback which you are going to get for your communication will be zero, nil. So always you need to be good listener. You need to try to overcome with your language barriers. At least basics of your language should be clear. You should try to accept all the cultures of different places. So cultural barrier will overcome. Try to be mentally, physically present. So your psychological, interpersonal, personal, emotional barriers will get overcome. Always try to have friends or communication with, you can say, irrespective of gender. So there you can overcome with gender barriers. Try to be cooperative in your organization. Give constructive feedbacks. So these all are the solutions and measures which will help you to overcome to your communication barriers. Okay, there are 7 C's for effective communication. Which all 7 C's are there? You need, see, when you're doing and you're having a conversation or communication, you need to be clear with what you're sharing. You need to be very concise, correct with the data which you're delivering. You should be complete. The statement, whatever you're making, should be complete. It should be concrete, based on some facts and figures. It should be coherent, that means it should be interrelated with each other, and it should be courteous. It should not hurt anyone's feeling. It should not get in touch with anyone's emotion. So the 7 C's are being followed, then your communication is going to be an effective communication. Now class, you are supposed to read this lesson. See, we have done this lesson offline. Now we are doing it again online. So I want you all to go through this lesson, read the lesson. If you have any doubts, put your doubts on the group. Okay, try to solve the exercise. Have a good day. Bye.